This episode of Dream Journal is going to be titled, I Dream of YouTubers, because recently I had a couple dreams that had YouTubers in it. The first one, not quite sure why, but I was going to a monster truck show. My wife didn't want to go, so she called somebody and asked them to meet me there so I wouldn't be by myself, because for some reason I was compelled to go to this monster truck show, which isn't really my thing, but whatever. So when I get there, the person that she had meet me was the Defender of Reason. Now, I'm not exactly sure why, but she's like, oh yeah, I know your wife from high school. I'm like, really? She's like, yeah, but that's irrelevant. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. So we're walking around looking for our seats, and there's a stage set up. Now, the sign said that Blues Traveler was playing, you know, the band from the 90s. Well, instead of Blues Traveler, it was Matt O'Neill and tomtomhungry. And after we watched their set, we continued on to go look for our seats, and I bump into Gear Up. Oh, yes. I bumped into Gear Up. He looks down at me and says, hey, I should kick your ass. I'm like, okay, for bumping into you? And he says, no, because you're on YouTube, and you're an atheist, and I don't like you. I was like, oh, well, okay, that's definitely your right to have that opinion, but if you want to fight, we can go outside in the parking lot and we'll fight. Defender of Reason looks over and says, no, he's just old and cranky. He needs laid or something. I'm like, well, yeah, probably, but still, whatever. Well, a very large hand comes across and taps my shoulder, and I look up, and it's Aaron Raw with his parrot on his shoulder. And he says, hey, I got this. I looked up at Gear Up, and Gear Up looked at me and looked at Aaron Raw. Then Aaron Raw says, Gear Up, haven't you learned your lesson yet? He says, oh, well, screw this anyway. I'm going to go get a corn dog. And Aaron Raw and Gear Up both walked off in separate directions. Never saw the monster trucks. That was it. Now, the second dream, I was looking for a car. Now, in real life, I was looking for a car for my wife and devoting a lot of time to it. And in my dream, which I had the night before we went to go pick up her car, it was almost like one of those adventure movies, like Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle, and you just never make it to where you're going. Well, I take off from the house, make a pit stop by what was supposed to be one of my friend's houses, and it turns out to be the house of a YouTuber called Helsing920. He does video game reviews and rants. Not sure how many of you are into that, but anyway, he looks at the car I was driving and says, hey, that's my old car. I want to buy it back from you. And I was like, okay, really? Because I was like trying to my friend, and you know, I'm trying to buy a second car. I don't really want to sell the first one. He's like, oh, but it has sentimental value. I've been saving up for 2 years to try to buy back my car. And for some reason I felt bad, and I was like, oh, well, okay. So I sold him back his car, and he invited me in the house and said, hey, we have pizza. I'm like, oh, okay. So I went in. There were a bunch of random people I don't know, and for some reason, he looked at the shirt that I was wearing and says, hey, that's my shirt too. Can I have it back? And I was like, oh, it was in the car when I got it, so I guess I assumed, you know, it was free or something. I don't know. That part just kind of, in my dream, I knew it, but I don't know why I would even say that or how that would happen. I mean, who gets a car with a free shirt in it? Whatever. So anyway, as I'm talking to the random people around the table, he walks off to go hang up his shirt, and I realize after taking off the shirt that I'm now in my underwear, but it doesn't seem to bother me for some reason. I'm just like, oh, wow, how'd that happen? Oh, well, there's pizza. So I'm eating a slice of pizza, and I hear a commotion in the other room, and somebody's going, God damn it, the cat's getting in the pizza box! And everybody went running, chasing after the cats, and I was like, okay, the car lot's going to close. I need to go get my wife's car, and now I need a ride. So I picked up the phone, and I called this other friend that I had back in high school, who died a year after high school, and he showed me the car that he had back then and picked me up. And after taking off, he insisted that he knew a shortcut to get there, and of course we got lost. I don't know how that ended up happening, but we found a little schoolhouse out in the middle of nowhere, out in the country, and there were people working on it, like contractors or something, redoing some tile flooring and, you know, wall panels and stuff. So I walked in and I said, hey, if you guys don't mind, I'd like to use one of the computers here and MapQuest this address, find out where I'm at and how to get where I'm going because my day is running out. So they let me use the computer. I MapQuest the car lot. I come out the front door and I run into a YouTuber called Faradir28, and he helped me get my car started, my friend's car started, because he took off with the keys but left the car. So Faradir28 helped me basically hotwire the car. I don't know, it was pretty odd, but that was it. I never made it to get the car that I was after. So, anyway, I just thought I'd share that with you. She thinks it's hilarious that the cat was stealing the pizza.